And those last few remaining men and women on strike still have not given up. News 8's Aly Myles spent this evening talking to the now unemployed workers about what their future holds. She joins us now live with our continuing coverage. Aly.
Yeah, Tracy, these folks have been out here for more than a week now, and they're still going strong, but their attitude is definitely not what it was when I spoke to them last Friday.
It's been sad. This is a sad end.
It's a game changer for many strikers at the Hostess Bakery in Biddeford.
The new plan is to move on and hopefully find another good job.
The atmosphere has changed. And the positivity that was here all week long has left, along with many of the strikers.
A lot of people out there think we make a stupid mistake by go striking, but you don't know what we've been through.
Now ex-employees of the bakery, many of the men and women say they don't know what they'll do if another baking company doesn't buy Hostess brands.
It should never come to this, but it hasn't. You know, we've dealt with it.
At 64 years old, Betsy Gonzalez says she was 16 months away from retirement before the company took her pension plan.
Don't have a job, don't have nothing now.
Gonzalez says both she and her husband worked at Hostess for 17 years.
When the people work hard, companies don't care. Companies don't think in a situation of the people. Company don't care.
Now, like thousands of others across the country, Gonzalez says she doesn't know what the two of them will do.
I never have in this situation. Never.
Folks I spoke to say they're incredibly grateful for the support and donations they've received from the community. They say it's little things like coffee and firewood that have kept them going strong and kept them warm. Reporting live in Biddeford, Aly Myles, News 8.